Alice Stude, and this is That's So 20 Show. And today we have special guests from the Great Gatsby here to talk about great inventions of the 1920s. Now introduce yourselves, cool cats.
Hey guys, I'm Tom. I was the most powerful man to ever come out of Yale. I'm a polo player, and I'm married to the sheep over here on my right.
Hi, I'm Daisy Buchanan, and I'm married to Tom Buchanan, and I love him very much.
Hi, I'm Nick Haraway. I'm just very, very happy to be here with all these fascinating people.
I'm Jordan Baker, and I really don't want to be here.
So Tom, tell us your favorite invention of the time period.
Well, that's a great question, but it's kind of personal, so I don't know if I should share it with you.
Oh, please tell us, Tom. Tom, wasn't that the time we had to go visit Dr. Eckelberg?
Well, I've had some bacterial infections in my life, like once, twice, five times.
12.
And ever since the invention of penicillin in 1928, I've been a more comfortable man.
Mm-hmm. Alexander Fleming, man, was a godsend.
It was truly a miracle drug.
Miller McCann, half a very, very bad news for you, very bad, very bad.
But what's wrong? What's wrong with me, though?
Is he gonna be okay?
I gotta tell you, seem to be covered in syphilis. Syphilis. Syphilis everywhere. Syphilis here, syphilis there, syphilis everywhere. Erect those then, acquire immediately. But there's a cure. Penicillin. The cure for all bacteria. I tell you, I never hear you before. I, he, how do you know?
Daisy, tell us your favorite invention.
Well, I must say that my favorite invention was the automatic windshield wipers. They're really helpful while I'm driving.
The automatic windshield wiper was invented in 1922 by, I believe it was, William M. Fulbright.
Now, Daisy, tell us why the windshield wiper is your favorite invention.
Well, when I'm driving, I could get into quite a bit of trouble with the fuzz, and let's just say it's best to clean up the evidence, and they're really helpful with that, if you know what I mean.
Oh, do I know what you mean?
I think you do.
Look! Okay. All better. Good thing I have my windshield wipers.
Jordan, it's your turn to tell us what your favorite invention is.
Well, I would need to take you to my house to show you everything, and me being the independent woman I am, I rarely have much time for myself. But thanks to all the new household appliances, I never have to worry about
Is my brand new toaster.
Oh, wow! I think I've heard about one of these things. I think it was made in 1929 by Charles Strait.
How do you pronounce it?
Toaster.
Toaster.
And even better, pre-sliced bread. You're kidding.
What?
You sliced it before we came.
Nope. And now I have more time.
You're a filthy liar.
Some champagne.
This is heresy.
For whenever I have visitors.
This is Hades.
Ooh, but I like it.
Tom, you have to get me a toaster.
All right, sweetie. We'll get one.
Cheers. Cheers to our toaster.
Better than sliced bread.
So what happens when it... Oh my god!
Well, I believe my favorite invention tops all of yours by a long shot.
Why don't you tell us about it?
Simply put, the radio is the bee's knees. Although it was not invented in the 20s, that is when it really flourished. Used mainly for news and advertisement, it assisted in the rise of consumer...
Can't wait to listen to my good old radio. Oh yeah, I love this station.
across America. Have a swanky night.
Your genitalia seems to be top door of goodness. Vernicelli.
Just my bit.
You can't see it. It's ghost riding.
What's your last name again? Dan.
And this is my kitchen. Katie.
Your genitalia seems to be top.
So dry.
Me being the inventive woman I am.
Oh, you can, never mind. It's all gray in this one, though.